Hello and welcome to a brand new video of Global Techniques of Architecture. I hope you guys are revising all your concepts in through the previous videos. So into this video specifically, we are going to talk about spandrel panels. So there is much more query. There are at least 10 queries onto my mail asking for what is a spandrel panel and how is it different from normal panels. So whenever or say wherever there is a slab, we need not, the architect need not intend to see that slab from the outside of the building. So in order to say hide that slab, what he does is he introduces a spandrel panel. Many a times into say non-continuous facades, these kind of details are say the function of these spandrels are being generally done by the masonry brickworks or say the RCC. But in case of a continuous facade, wherein there is a continuous facade, so in that case spandrel comes into picture, and that spandrel has to perform very specific functions. So when I say specific functions, I intend that it has to stop the floor to floor propagation of fire, number one. Number two, it must also act as acoustic barrier from floor to floor. Number three, in case of fire, it must not only prevent the fire from traveling from floor to floor, but also the smoke. So if at all you look at the entire assembly of a spandrel panel, this would be basically of mineral wool or rock wool or glass wool with a specific density as desired by the consultant, depending upon the functionality, the importance of the building. Okay, then we have aluminium flashing that covers the entire thing, the bracket and all those things, and over and above we have intumescent sealant for the fire part. There is another system company which has also got into fire barrier, wherein they don't use this intumescent sealant, and they say that the entire assembly, they call it as dry assembly, performs as good as the wet assembly, wherein intumescent sealant and all those other parameters that we discussed are involved. So either of these must be used for the spandrel panel. Now this spandrel panel can be sometimes with just a single glass. It can be sometimes with a cladding material. It can be with the ACP. It can be with a terracotta. It can be depending upon the look and feel of the building, depending upon the functionality of the building, how the architect perceives or say rather conceives the building. Depending upon all those parameters, this would be decided. So irrespective of the skin, the vertical skin that is being used in front of that slab line, we have to maintain, number one, the aesthetics from the outside. Number two, from behind, we need to have these three basic technical integrity into the spandrel panel. Number one, fire. Number two, smoke. Number three, acoustic. And last but not the least, many a times people have ignored spandrel panels like ho jayega, chal jayega. So what they do is they have even used back painted glasses, or many a times they have just filmed the glasses. This filming of glass in long term just gets peeled off and serves of no purpose for spandrel area. There was a query onto the mail that can spider glazing be done for the entire building? The answer is yes. But if at all these three functions, floor to floor, fire, smoke and acoustic, are not your consideration, of course go for it. But if yes, then no. Spider glazing can be used only for double height entrance and atrium areas, irrespective of that being a fin system, a cable net, tension rod, or just vertical mullion system. but to be used only in atrium as well as entrance systems. Whenever and wherever there are slabs, say which are for an office building, for an IT building, for a hospital, by default the functionality calls for, the intent calls for these three parameters. I hope spandrel as a panel is being clear to you. Last point I would like to emphasize is that if at all these spandrel panels are, the material used for these spandrel panels are chosen very wisely, you can be achieving a greater U value. Now what is U value, we'll be covering in the next video. So overall U value of the, or say the overall performance of your building moving towards green building accreditation will be, say you would be getting more brownie points over there. So this brings us to the end of this video wherein spandrel panels are being cleared to you. I hope you have enjoyed the video, and if yes, press the like button and do share it with your friends for sharing the knowledge. Once again, thanks for watching.